So in this new tutorial, we're gonna deal with making more objects without actually making them. So how do you multiply an object in Blender? It's very, very simple. It's one of the simplest things you can actually do. Right click on the object while in object mode and duplicate it. Shift D gives you a duplicate that you can put next to this one. I'm gonna enlarge just the base. So you're gonna have two objects that are independent from each other. So basically, if I go here and I modify this, for example, I pull this in or I pull this out like that. Let's see. Forget about the texture because it's stretching. It's just for an experiment. This one will stay the same. It will not change. Control Z, as usual, to undo any damage. But there's another mode where you can actually modify what you want and have everything follow the same thing. And I'm going to teach you in a second. But first, have a look at what you can actually do by having different objects. So, if I wanted to make, for example, a tavern, duplicate, that, I would have several tables and a central table like that. Or if I want to make something particular, let's try this. Rotate Z 90, so always use the numbers to do this. And you have this here, I'm going to eliminate this one, this here, and S, X, make it smaller, here. So I'm going to make a scene eventually out of all of this, so I'm pre-positioning things for you to follow so that you get the same scene and the satisfaction of having done something like this. And I duplicate this, and I put it S, Y, make it much smaller, S, Z, make it a bit taller, and I put it here on the side. Okay. So, all different tables out of one table, and I didn't have to do much. But the thing is, I may want to have, I don't know, hundreds of tables or hundreds of objects. For example, if I put, I don't know, a small object on the floor. For now, we'll do it with tables because I don't want you to go and do something different. But I'll take one. And here, in edit mode, select everything. And I'll do select. I keep on forgetting this one because I barely use it. But it is a very useful thing to do. Object, and then duplicate linked. You select this one. Instead of doing duplicate objects, you do duplicate linked. And this one will be special, because if I go on edit mode, and I start moving this, look at the other table. It does exactly the same thing. So I can have several objects next to each other, and all of them, whenever I change them, will change. That doesn't mean that the objects are completely linked. If I go in object mode, and then I try to change the size or the shape of this object, this one will not be affected. For example, I do size, make it smaller. Yeah. The other one doesn't change in size. But if I go in edit mode, and I change this object, the other one will react regardless of being of a different size or different shape. So edit mode allows it to be constantly modified. And to show you the power of this thing, I'm just gonna do an example, give you several tables, multiply them to, right, something like that. And then I'm gonna go edit a random one, this one. There you go. coupled, they're all like that. And that's because I duplicated only, I just duplicated those two. So duplicate works on linked objects. But what if I want everything to be linked? So instead of going duplicate, now I'm gonna go in object and duplicate linked, object, duplicate linked, object, duplicate linked. And let's try this. This is gonna be fun. Edit, select, every single one of those objects will do the same exact thing. So if you're trying to populate quickly an environment, for example, I wanted to put pots or glasses or plates around this, I just need to make one plate, place it there, and then duplicate it, make a lot of copies, or duplicate linked and make a lot of copies that will interact with each other and be exactly the same. So this is one of the very powerful tools in Blender that are rarely used but very useful. So another thing, let's start another object. So I'm gonna add a cube, mesh cube. Generally I just use cubes because they're the most modifiable ones, so I don't really go into a lot more complicated stuff. So what I do here is SZ, make it flat. Now I go into edit mode and I want to make a roof tile. Roof tiles are quite messy and complicated, so I do Shift R, remember how we cut things, and I give it a few lines. But you can see is if I select a line and I pull it, only that line will come up. So there's another tool in Blender that is very useful for this, and it's this proportional editing. So basically I edit one and everything else around it will follow. And what it does, I use the mouse wheel when I'm pulling it, I use the mouse wheel to enlarge this circle, and it increases or decreases the area of effect. So I want a tile that has this part a bit flatter and this one a bit higher. That's it. Make it a bit longer. I want it as a Roman tile, so I'm gonna do it. Remember to remove this when you're doing small modifications. So I'm gonna stretch this, add this, and face selection, E as usual, and that. That's a Roman tile. So I have this edge, remember, a face, remember, it's shade smooth, so I have a smooth tile. And now, with the object mode, I do duplicate linked. I have two linked tiles. Make them smaller, because tiles are smaller than that. And that's it. I can keep on doing add object, duplicate, linked. And there's a quicker way to do this. It's Shift D, Alt D, sorry. Shift D is for duplicating, Alt D is to duplicate linked. And then I can just keep on going. Now let's say I wanted all the tiles a bit squished on the side or broken, just to add a little bit more detail to it. I would go that. So proportional editing will allow me to squish a little bit while the tiles, and go, I'll just do it in a small circle, very small circle, so just to give it this here. And you see all the tiles are following the same. So you can modify an entire roof without having to constantly go back and forth to redo it. But remember to do the duplicate linked when you're doing multiple objects, especially if they are going to be all the same. Don't do it if you want them to be different at the end, because then duplicate linked would stop it from happening. But if you want them all the same, Alt D, and you'll have a roof in no time. Now, what if we want to render this entire scene? So basically take a physical picture of it. This is something that needs to be done in case you want a picture of the object, or if you want to render scenes that then end up becoming a game or things like that. So rendering is very important. It adds everything together and shows a full picture of it. As you can see, and we never touched it before, we have a camera here. The camera renders the area. So if you have a camera like this, which you should have in the default setting, and you go into up here, render, and you go render image, it will render the image. But as you can see, it only renders a particular area, nothing else. And this is because the camera is pointing in that direction. To see what the camera is seeing, go in view, camera, active camera, and you see where the camera is seeing. If you move, you get out of the camera view. So view, camera, active camera. If you press shift, you can move around. Instead, if you move with the selection mode like this, and do RZ, for example, the camera will move. You cannot see the circle or anything, but you can move the camera. So G, S moves on the S G. I'm sorry. G X will move on the X axis. G Y to move on the Y axis. But what if you wanna look with the camera without getting out all the time? What you can do is lock camera to 3D cursor. Oh, sorry. Lock camera. View. Second. View cameras. Active camera. Lock camera to visual, which is the second one. And now, whenever you move, the camera moves with you. You cannot get out of the camera view. So if I want to be very precise on what I'm going to render, which is, I don't know, like this. I'm going to look at it from the top like that. And then I press render. It will see all the things that I placed inside the camera area. The other thing is, you want to save this image. I mean, it's not going to be just rendered and that's it. So image, save as, and then wherever you are, when you save your files, you do this. You call it tables, for example. Save image, and now you'll have it. Save it in there. Get out, and that's done. If you want to get out of this mode with the camera holding, you just press again, untick the camera view, and you get out. That's it. Okay, and that's it for today. Hope this was useful, and there's more to come, a lot more to come. And you'll start slowly building your world from now on, so you'll see.